In this video, we are discussing data modeling overview. Now, what is data modeling? Data modeling or data structuring is actually denoting the type of data and the business logic to control that data. And that is known as the data modeling, can also be called as data structuring. So let us go for some more details about it. So the data modeling or data structuring represents the nature of data and the business logic to control the data. It also organizes the database. So the structures of data are explicitly determined by the data model. So this particular data model will actually decide what will be the structure of the data, and that will be decided explicitly. Data model helps to communicate between the business people who requires a solution, so who requires a computer system, and the technical people who is going to implement the respective solution and will provide the service to these business people. So the data model helps to communicate between the business people who requires a computer system and the technical people who can fulfill their requirements. So that's why data modeling is so important. So the data modeling concept has three levels, and these three levels are like this. First one is the conceptual model, next one is the logical model, and the last one is the physical model. Now, what is the conceptual model? We have written a very summary for it. So being the scope of a model, it helps to describe the semantics of the domain. So it is not actually related that how the data will be stored, what will be the respective data types. It is not dealing with that. It is dealing with the semantics of the domain. Semantic means meaning. So being the scope of a model, it helps to describe the semantics of a domain. Now let us go for the next phase, that is the logical model. In this model, there are descriptions of tables, columns, object-oriented classes, XML tags, document structures, and so on. So here we are having all the detailed descriptions. So this model, there are descriptions for tables, columns, object-oriented classes, XML tags, and document structures, and so on. Next one is a physical model, and this particular model is actually dealing with the fact that how the data will be stored into shards and in other way. So this model cares about the actual physical structure to store our data, and like the partitions, CPU spaces, replications, shards, etc. So this is known as the physical model. It is dealing with the fact that how the data will be stored. So let us go for a quick summary. So conceptual model, in this model, the concept or semantics of the data models are concerned. We don't need to care about the actual data and their required meta information. Next one is the logical model. The model consists of the table or document descriptions, etc. And these document structures are defined in this model. Last one is the physical model we discussed earlier also. How the actual data can be stored into the system, these are defined in this model, and it manages the replications, shards, etc. and physically. So here we have discussed what is the data modeling overview in our MongoDB. Thanks for watching this video.